guys, back here with another video, and today we're talking about the European Bench Press Championships. This is my first IPF international competition, and let's just say it went pretty damn good. So I'll talk you through like the entire process, the flights, all that good stuff. If you're on the Instagram, you'll have seen all the stuff I put up on my stories, sort of like talking all through all this. So we flew out, left my house at about 12 o'clock midnight on a Friday morning, to get to Luton Airport for 3 o'clock for a 6 o'clock flight. All that, nice, smooth, perfect. Luton Airport were cheaper, that's why we went that bit further. Considerably cheaper, I'd imagine. Again, my dad tends to handle that side of stuff. He has done that very well with all of the IPF internationals, the amount of, but if you get to that level, and hopefully we all do, if that's the Fed you live for, you will see, obviously, you've got a lot of paperwork you've got to fill out. That's not my thing, I lift, so I just let him sort all that out, so he's obviously sorted all that good stuff out. We got Lander, the time zone difference is 2 hours ahead of the UK, so it was a 4 hour flight. We left at 6, but it was 12 over there, which was nice, early, you know, so earlier bedtime. Well, you know, sort of, you get what I mean. So we got airport, the IPF put on like shuttles from the hotel to the airport, and the airport to the hotel, which are optional. So for some run we've taken them, like when we go to South Africa we'll be taking it, because it's a very long journey. However, for this one, we looked at the cost of the Uber, and the Uber was just a tad cheaper, so we took that option. We're back to save every penny we can. Get your accreditation from hotel. I'm saying all that, like, if you get all, it'll all make a bit more sense if you read the paperwork and all that stuff. But you know, basically we travelled for about 15 hours, bit time. We got our hotel for about 3 o'clock, had a nice look round, speak to a few people, get familiar with who's going to be handling me on the day, try some local food, stuff like that. Nice night, all good. Solid 8.5 hours sleep for the big comp. Had some breakfast on that day, which was the morning of this is, 2 flapjacks, weighed in at 81.6, we'd been bench only, we'd not paid a particular amount of attention to our body weight, we'd just sort of let it be what it'll be, didn't bother cutting or anything really, just let it be what it is. For full powers we like to just drop that little bit of a kilo, just for the points. I doubt we'll do that at Worlds, just because we won't be that big as we can, let's not chance anything. You know, we want the kilos rather than the points. So, weighed all in, ran to the hotel breakfast, just a little bit of food, just porridge really, that's all I had. Met up with Martin, he's the British team head coach. I feel like an idiot, I can't remember his surname, but Matt. Yeah, we had him there as well, and loads of other people that were there helping as well, but those two mainly. Yeah, we worked here with a shirt, got it all nice, warm-ups felt great, feeling very confident for my 220 opener, which you will see on the video that I'm going to put on at the end. It should have been a no lift, but it was 3 white lights, and my bump came up, which was unusual, but it hasn't happened at all in training. And it happened on my second attempt. Even though the second attempt was a no lift, I didn't get the lift at all. And my third attempt, I also didn't. I got my opener in, and then just went bold for the world record. I knew my opener would secure me the best lifter, as well as gold. And that's what I wanted. And then world record, let's just go for it. Coincidentally as well, we got the Commonwealth bench press record. For sub-juniors, and we wasn't far off the Commonwealth Junior record, which is nice. You don't hear many people talking about Commonwealth records, so let's try and make them relevant. But that was that. Let's show you the medals. Got a nice participation medal, the big gold medal, and the best lifter. So, participation medal, nice white ribbon medal with the event logo, and another event logo that I've never seen before advertising the event, which is good. Again, nice logo, EPF, the EPF is, which is the European region of the IPF, and the European Bench Press Championships, the event, TPSSF, that must be a sponsor, and then the big gold medal with the event on it, 2024, and the European European Powerlifting Federation logo on the back. And then the big one, the best lifter award with the EPF on the back and then the event logo on the front. Managed to get it in home unscathed in the suitcase, wrapping it up in all the clothes that we'd got. It's a very prestigious award, this, and I'm going to treasure this one. It has completed the two bookcases I've got. I don't know if you can see all the way to the top, but all the top row is full, even like the roof of the... But you know what I mean, you've got your shelves and then you've got like the top that you don't normally stack things on, but I do because I've got that many things. So I'm going to have to find a new bookcase to use, trying to scavenge one of them up. But yeah, overall very good event. We did that, bought the event t-shirt, which I will go and grab now, just one second. Still keeping it in its SPD packaging. Actually wore this yet. This is the first time I'm putting it on. I'm gonna get the event t-shirt for every event that I go to, internationals that is, because I was debating, you see people that get the new like GB singlet every time, or their national fed singlet, but they cost a little too much money to get every single time, so I'm just gonna get the event t-shirt. But there we have it, SBD the sponsor on the left, EPF on the right, and then the event in the middle. Nothing on the back, plain back. But like I said, that about does it for this week. We are very shortly heading out to the World Championships, the World Junior Championships, which I'm hoping for the... hopefully get the best lifter, the gold medal, you know. That'd be very nice, going 2 for 2, best lifters and golds at my two international comps. Realistically, what are we hoping for with records? I'm hoping to walk away with squat gold. This will be my most ambitious one of the day. Me and Vlad, we're going to battle for that squat gold. Potentially the squat world record, but definitely the squat European record. Bench press, the record's there if I want to have a stab at it, the world one that is, or if I want to. The world and European are the same, but I think I'm going to end up shooting just under it to try and build the total. The record's 235, I think I might just shoot 2.5 less just to build the total. Let's not get distracted by that number. Then we've got the deadlift, bench press gold nailed on, should be anyway. I don't think the other top bench presser from America will be coming. Lilo Lawson, I don't think he'll be there. I know he did NAPF where he was unsuccessful at getting the record, which is a shame. It would be nice, you know, that'd be a nice boost. And deadlift, that should be a nailed on gold and European record. World record, I think, is a tad out of reach if everything's locked up. See what totals are about, but we may have a stab at it. May. Probably won't, because it'll be a nicer total that I'd want, but we may have a stab at it. See how things are moving. We will be putting a suit back on for that. Undecided, that will be the Velocity 34. Undecided with a squat, if it's going to be a squat suit that I've got recently, or if I'm going to go with the Velocity again. Either way, I'm going to squat something big. Totals again will annihilate the European one. You saw what I did at the Manchester Open there, you get that with a stupid amount on the record. It's a world record, it put about 12 and a half on it, and that was missing two benches. We will not be missing two benches this time around. I will be very, I believe I've not gone 3 for 3 on benches equipped this year, so we will be going 3 for 3 on bench. We will be going 3 for 3 on squats. Again, we're not accepting anything less than 8 for 8 and potentially missing that 9th pull. But let me finally wrap this up. Thank you for watching. I'm going to leave you with the only with the first bench press. You don't need to see the two failed. But until next time, keep lifting that big weight.